Often, people misunderstood what is repentance. There's two kinds of repentance. There's a worldly repentance and a godly repentance. Worldly repentance means being sorrow, being sad. Okay? Everybody can be sad. Everybody can be sorrow. Okay? But they are not really inside. They are not really repented. It's not really repenting. Okay? People out there, you're probably one of those people that use this word every time you make a mistake, every time you did these wicked things, and you will say, I'm sorry, I mess up again. I want to tell you, that's not what the Bible says. That's not repenting.
So also forgiveness of sin cannot be understood without repentance.
That repentance is simply means to turn away from sin and turn to God.
If you die right now, where would you go?
To repent means to confess sin and forsake it. You're saying, this is enough. I don't like it. I don't want it.
Iniquities.
Your iniquities has
separated
you from God.
Verse 18 says, when they heard this, they had no further objections. And praise God, saying, so then God has granted even the Gentiles repentance unto life.
This is why Paul preached repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. Acts 20 verse 21.
To all sinners to repent. Matthew chapter 9 verse 13. Okay. The first public word he preached was repent. Mm-hmm. John the Baptist began his ministry the same way. Matthew chapter 3 verse 2. Jesus told his hearers twice that without repentance, they will perish.
If believing, only believing to Jesus will bring us to him, then Jesus will not preach that message, repent, and John the Baptist will not preach that message also. Most convert believes, and yet it's not saved. Whoa. Okay? False convert. Believes. Do you remember, or do you know that even the devil believes? Yeah? And the devil not only believes, he was what? The Bible says he was trembling. This word of believe, okay, is not really a key for salvation. Of course, it's good if we believe. Okay, that's part of it. Okay? But many people misunderstood this. They stop from that. Only believing. But that, they are not repenting. They are not turning away from their wicked ways. They are not turning away from their sins. They're still believing in Jesus, and yet still doing their old ways. Either you're in or you're out. You're for Jesus or you're not for Jesus. You choose which one you are. Either you repent, turn away from those sin, from those wickedness, and walk for Jesus. Or you believe in Jesus, but not repent and still carry all those sins and all those wickedness in you, and you walk and you believe in Jesus. Remember what the Hebrew says? Hebrew says, okay, let us throw everything that entangles us, that easily entangles us. You know, Hebrew is talking about sin. Okay, how can we take that away? We need to repent. It's not really committed. To turn away, okay? And making his heart right before God, he's not ready. Filipinos are very good in words, okay? We are very good. This is for Cho's knowledge and information about Filipinos, because you might encounter people like this, okay? Filipinos are very good in what do you call this? making other people happy.
Pleasing.
Pleasing, yes. Filipinos, a people pleaser. Okay, when you ask them, do you want to accept Jesus? Are you ready to receive Jesus? Oh, yes. I believe in Jesus. Okay, we'll pray. But inside, they're not really ready. And then after that, okay, after that prayer that you will make, okay, the next day you will see their lives again. You will see them doing the same way, doing the same thing that they're doing. Okay, so be careful of that, Filipino. So if you discern in your heart that the person is not really making a true heart commitment to the Savior, then he is not ready. If God is drawing, you know, if God the Father is drawing someone to Jesus, it means he's also drawing away from sin. And it's the same way with God the Father. Okay? When God the Father drawing people to Jesus, he's at the same time drawing them away from their sins.
Look at the warning of Scripture. If you say that we have fellowship with him and walk in the darkness, we lie and do not the truth. 1 John chapter 1 verse 6. The scripture also say, he that covers his sin shall not prosper, but whoso confesses and forsake them, repent, shall have mercy. Proverbs 28 verse 13. If there is no repentance, there is no joy, because there is no salvation.
Okay? I remember what Psalms 23. You know, the Lord is my shepherd. I remember, you know, when I was reading there, I found out, you know, without the shepherd, there's no life, there's no direction, there's no protection. Nothing. Okay? Nothing. It's the same way here. No repentance. No life.
There is no remission of sins. Mm-hmm. We are still under God's wrath. Peter's father said, repent and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. Acts 3 verse 19. We cannot be converted or have our sins blotted out unless we repent. God himself commanded all men everywhere, leaving no exemptions, to repent. Acts 17 verse 30. Peter said a similar thing at Pentecost. Repent and be baptized, every one of you. Acts 2 verse 38. Clearly, those who do not repent will perish.
If a man doesn't know what sin is, how can he repent? Any repentance will be merely horizontal repentance.
And in this, in all these verses that we have read, Psalms 51 verse 4, Genesis 39 verse 9, Luke 15, 21, Acts 20, 21, all of those verses talks about God. Okay? Talks about asking forgiveness, repenting before God. You think it would be easier to tell sinners believe than to tell them they need to repent? I'm sorry, I'm going to speak in Tagalog. We say it, masarap mamuhay sa kasalanan, kaya ayaw iwanan. Okay? Pero yung maniwala ka, if you only believe in God, it's easy. Okay? It's easy. I remember some of my friends, I told them, how come you're still smoking? Oh, bro, it's hard for me to quit. You know, and I love it. But if I tell them, do you believe in God? Oh, of course. Right away, like that, okay? So for me, that's my answer.
Sometimes, you know, believe is more lighter than repent.
Okay.
And sometimes, when we are using belief, we most of the times tell of the good things again. You know, we are telling somebody, when you believe, you know, this is going to happen to you, and it gives the person more encouragement. But when you are telling somebody to repent, you are telling him to stop what he is doing, the wrong, what he feels he's enjoying, and you are telling him to stop it.
True salvation without repentance is no salvation at all.